Joining us to talk further about this, Randy Kessler, one of the top divorce attorneys in the country. He's handled cases involving Michael Jordan, Usher, also author of the book, and I have it right here, Divorce, Protect Yourself, Your Kids, and Your Future. All right, big issue here, and you and I talked about it yesterday, worth revisiting. She wants physical custody. I want to read, though, a quote when you talk about what did Angelina Jolie think of Brad Pitt as a parent. This is from a couple of years ago, Randy, where she said, "It's such a beautiful and sexy quality in a man when he takes his responsibilities as a father very seriously. I still get very emotional when I watch Brad play with the children. He's so naturally devoted and joyful around them." Again, a couple of years ago, but could that come up and potentially hurt her case against him?
No, it might have the opposite effect. You know, a lot of times the people that are awarded custody by the judge are the people that say the nicest things about the other side. Just because he might be a great dad doesn't mean she thinks he's a better parent or the kids should live with him. So he could still be a good dad, but she is saying that she thinks she should be the person that primarily is in charge. And she might well be saying that he should have a lot of time. Look, they've got six kids. I don't know how two parents handle six kids, much less one. So they're going to be with both the parents, and they're going to have nannies. They've got resources. I don't read as much into it as everybody else's. You got to check a box. She checked the custody box.
Okay. Well, let's flip to the other side, and you kind of touched on it. This is Brad on Angie to a parade saying this: "One of the greatest, smartest things I ever did was give my kids Angie as their mom. She's such a great mom. Oh, man, I'm so happy to have her with a partner like Angie. I know that when I'm working, the kids are happy, safe, and prospering. And when Angie's working, she knows she has the same." And this is the heart of why people are so surprised. We thought they had it all. And again, to you on those quotes, does it surprise you to see that, or have you seen this before in your years of work?
Well, you know, nothing surprises me anymore. Doing divorce work for 30 years, it's very hard to shock me. But, you know, they didn't get married at first. Let's remember that. They were together. Apparently, their kids wanted them to get married, which is understandable. They wanted to be a family. They got married. But maybe they had it right the first time. Just because you're good parents doesn't mean you have to stay married. You might not love each other, but you love your kids.
Married a couple of years. Let's bring in Dr. Robbie Ludwig, psychotherapist, author of the book, Till Death Do Us Part. Robbie, let's get back to the beginning here. This story, national obsession, national sadness, we're picking sides. Why are we so obsessed?
Well, I think that Angelina and Brad were the symbol of true love, and we all felt like we really knew this couple. We were invested in their succeeding. They seemed to be very happy. They had everything going for them. Their beautiful, successful careers. They created this wonderful family. Most people didn't see it coming. I have to say, I didn't see it coming, and I was very sad when I heard about the news. It just felt disappointing, like, why, you too? Can't you make it?
That's it. That was the reaction. And then, like I mentioned, people picking sides, Team Brad, Team Angie, and then there's Jennifer Aniston. I mean, it was immediate. People going to social media, one meme after another, basic theme, she's probably gloating now. Why do we go there so quick?
Well, I think it is a human natural reaction probably for an ex-partner to have a little bit of happiness knowing that an ex-husband couldn't make it in their next relationship. We, of course, don't know that Jennifer feels that way at all, but it's how people project how they would feel if they were in Jennifer's situation. And some of the memes were very funny.
Yeah.
But I would bet that Jennifer has moved on and would want happiness for Brad eventually.
Hey,
probably feels happy that she's in a happy place.
Yeah, there you go. Hey, last one to you, Randy. What do you expect? Do you expect some bloodbath or not as this plays out?
I don't. I mean, she's got a wonderful lawyer, Laura Wasser, and Neil Hirsch has been rumored to be his lawyer. You know, these lawyers that handle these big cases, they know how to solve it. They're going to get professionals involved. They're going to be mediators, maybe a private judge. I mean, their very, very last resort would be a bloodbath in court, because that doesn't help the kids.
Yeah, you mentioned it. Number one, the six kids. And you talk about money. They're worth together about $400 million.
Yeah,
so we'll see how that plays out. Robbie, Randy, guys, appreciate it. Thanks so much. Hey, we got new details coming out about the bombing.